Hi children, very good morning to all. I'm very happy to see you again. We are going to see about fruits and seeds. Last class we saw about flowers. Is it children? Have you all read the lesson? You all thorough in the topic? Yes, just we'll recap flowers. Okay children, now look at this picture and we know that flower is a reproductive part of the plant and it has very attractive and colorful petals and more fragrant petals, is it? Yeah, the outer part, that colorful part is called as petals. That green color part, no, that is called sepal. Inside that we have male and female reproductive part. Male reproductive parts are anther and filament. Anther can produce pollen grains. Okay children, the next one is female reproductive part. Look at this picture at the right side. Female reproductive part is called carpel. Carpel consists of stigma, style and ovary. Male reproductive part is called stamen. That stamen consists of filaments and anther. Okay children, next one is pollination. It can happen the self-pollination and cross-pollination. There are two types of pollination. Pollination is transfer of pollen grains from anther to the stigma. Okay, if it pollinates, if it transfers from a single flower from anther to stigma, that is called self-pollination. If this if the pollen grains transfer from one anther to the another flower stigma is called cross pollination. Okay children, after pollination you will get fruit and seed. Now that's all about the recap of flowers. Now we are going to see about how fruits and seeds are produced. Okay children, now look at this. What is this? This colorful part? Yeah, fruits. Do you like fruit children? Yes, of course, everyone like fruits. Is it? It's very tasty and delicious. Is it? Each and every fruit are different. Is it children? Yes. Fruits can only produced by the flowering plants. We have some of the non-flowering plants also there. Okay children, non-flowering plants cannot produce fruits. Flowering plant can only produce fruits. Look at this. After this pollination, okay, pollination of the flower, the fertilizer ovules develop into seeds. Okay, that surrounding ovary, you know, that will develop into fruit. Okay children, now look at this picture. It is a cycle of what is that? Producing flower from the seed and fruit. Okay, look at this first picture, flower picture. Just it is fertilization has happened, that is pollination happened. It has ovary, ovule. Inside that ovary you have ovule, is it? That part is called a zygote. That is a egg part of the flower is called as zygote. Then after the pollination, petals, what will happen? Petals started drying. You have noticed, is it? Noticed in your home. After some days, after blooming the flowers, it will, all those petals are fall away, then started giving fruit. Is it children? Then petals fall away, then embryo, that is inside that ovary, embryo can started develops. Okay children, then after some days seeds can develop from the ovule. I already told you, ovules can produce seeds and ovary can produce the fruit. Then seeds can develop from the ovule. Then after few days fruits develop from the ovary. Side by side the seeds also develop inside the ovule. After some days, what will happen? Fruit ripens flower parts fall away, then the ovary part become fruits and the ovule part becomes the seed. Okay children, then look at this. From flower to fruit to seed. Okay, typical flowers, all the flowers, most of the flowers have, not most of the flowers, all flowers have male part and the female reproductive part. Okay, already I told you, male part stamen consists of filament and anther, carpel consists of stigma, style and ovary. Okay, all the flowers have male and female reproductive parts. Male parts consist of anther and filament. Female parts consist of stigma, style and ovary. Okay, this male part, that anther, produces the pollen grains. Is it pollen or sperm? Okay, another name of a pollen, we can call that as a sperm. Then female parts include stigma, and inside the stigma we have pollen tubes. Inside you can see that ovary. Is it inside that ovary you can see ovules, in which contains egg, that small seed like structure, no, that is called ovule. Inside that, inside it contains egg. Okay children, next, pollen enters the flower, that pollen grains, no, from anther, it enters the flower's ovary. How it will enters into the ovary? Yes, of course, due to pollination. During the pollination, the anther sticking on the stigma. From the stigma, it is those sperm taken, passing through the pollen tubes through the style. Okay, children, the ovary grows and the petals fall off. That I already told you, no? After some days, after pollination, the flower petals fall off. The ovules can develop inside the ovary. Okay? Finally, the outer layer of the ovary becomes thick. Okay? And it form a fruit. And inside that ovary, the seed can form around, seed can form, and it start, while the fruit matured, the seed also grows and it also matured. Okay, seeds and fruits. After the pollen gets into the ovule, the plant can make a seed, that we know already. Is it children? Look at the seed. It's a very colorful, no? Yeah, black and red colorful seeds. Seeds may be inside fruits. Is it? I told you, no, most of the seeds are inside the fruits, such as apples, orange, berry, all the vegetables like a tomato, cucumber, then most of lady's finger, brinjal, everything. I said the seeds can be spread after fruit, after the fruits ripen. What will happen? That seeds can be spread by the wind or animals or person who eat the fruits and seeds. Is it that we can see in the seed dispersal? Okay children, the ovary develops into the fruit, the ovule into the seed. Okay, the fruit develops from the following layer. Okay, what are the following layers? Fruit wall from the ovary, it is a main important thing. Fruit wall from ovary wall, seed from the ovule, that is, these are the two main steps. Okay, fruit from the ovary, seed from the ovule. Okay children, next one, till now we saw about the fruits, is it? Now we are going to see about seed parts. Okay, now look at the seed. Look at the seed. What is that? Maybe bean seed, is it? Now outer layer, no, the out, look at the parts, ma, listen to the parts. The outer layer, no, the outer layer of the seed is called as seed coat. Okay children, that it is a dicot seed. If you divide, you can be divided into two equal halves. Okay children, if it is divided into two equal halves, it is a dicot seed. Okay, that equal halves, no, that seed, That is called as dicotyledon. What is that called? Cotyledon. It can store the food. Seed coats its outer layer. It can protect the seed. Okay. The next one is radical. What is radical? Yeah, of course, it is a root part of the plant. From the seed, which emerges out from the seed during germination? Yes, that is root part, that is radical, comes out first. And then plumule. What is plumule? Plumule is a younger leaf. Okay, early, it is like a leaf, the early development before the shoot system. Okay, that leaf part is called as plumule. The next one is hypocotyl. Hypocotyl can develop into stem. Okay, plumule is the leaf part. After that, this hypocotyl is the stem part. Okay, radical, it becomes root. Okay, children? Yes, it is given clearly in the picture here. Yes, look at this picture. That brown color layer, no? That is called as seed coat. Okay? This plumule is the leaf part. Radical is the root part. It emerges first. Okay? It comes out from the seed first during germination. Epicotyl, that stem, that before the leaf, that stem part. Hypocotyl, it is a part, connects the radical and the shoot system. The next one is cotyledon. You can see, you know, these two are cotyledon. It can store the food for the baby plant. Okay, children? Yes, look at this. This leaf part is plumule or epicotyl. It will become shoot, that leaves and stem. Epicotyl becomes leaves and stem. Hypocotyl, it's a part, it connects the cotyledon and the radical. Okay, children, it is attached. Before started germination, it is attached. After that also, it is attached with the cotyledon. After grown, the roots are fixed into the soil and it started preparing food by their own. After that only, those cotyledon fall down. Until the part, cotyledon part is attached with the plant. That part is called hypocotyl. Okay. Radical is the root part that I already told you. Is it? Cotyledon is a seed leaf. Seed leaf, no? It is contain two equal halves, I told you, no? That is called as cotyledon. It can store the food for the baby plant. Okay. The outer cover is called as seed coat. It is a dicot seed, bean seed. Next, explanation of the parts of the seed. Till now we saw the pictures, the diagram of the seed. Now I'm going to explain the parts of the seed. The embryo. What is embryo? Yeah, it is the little plant, little baby plant. Baby plant is called as embryo. If the embryo, that baby plant wants to grow, it needs some favorable conditions. Okay, it has some favorable conditions to develop a baby plant from the seed. Okay, what are the important favorable conditions? Yeah, favorable conditions are, it should need correct temperature. Okay, then moisture, that is water. Okay, children, next one, air. These three are very important for germination. After that, sunlight is important for the growth. For the germination, sunlight is not necessary because all the food for the growth of baby plant, that is taken from the cotyledon. Is it, children? So these three are very important. Temperature, then water and air. Okay, children, then next one, three important parts. We already saw, that is it, plumule. Plumule is a leaf-like structure. It is early development from the seed. Then it develops into the baby shoot system. Okay, leaf and shoot system. radical, yes, it comes out first. After that only the plumule emerges. Radical is the first part, comes out from the seed and it is called as root. Okay, it develops into the root of the plant. Next one is cotyledon, that is food storage part is called as cotyledon. Till the plant started preparing their own food, this cotyledon provides food for the baby plant. Okay, we know that there are two types of seeds. One is dicot seeds and monocot seeds, is it? I already told you, no, dicot seeds can divided into two equal halves. Okay, example, pea, oak, bean, soya bean, peanut, channa, all those green gram, all those are dicot seeds. Okay, they have two cotyledons, okay, in their seeds. Monocot seeds are at a single seed. It cannot have two cotyledons. It have only one cotyledon in their seeds. It cannot be divided into two equal halves. Okay, children? Now, the last part, that is germination of a seed. First, look at the seed. After absorbing water from the absorbing water by the seed coats can break and the radical comes out. Look at the second picture. Little bit there is a broken part, is it? Broken part on the seed coat. Breaking up the seed coat, the radical comes out. Before that radical, that part is called hypocotyle. It is attached with the, what is that? Seed coat. Okay. Then next one, the seed coat fallen. Then after that root fix into the soil. Then the hypocotyle started develop. Hypocotyle is the part which connects in between the root part and the leaf part. Okay. Look at this cotyledon. It is there to provide food for the baby plant. Okay, now look at this for last before picture. The roots fixing into the soil and the cotyledon started open and it's a foliage leaf, that is a young leaf. Okay, young leaf, it started the last picture, it fixed into the root fixed into the soil, it started preparing their own food. Okay, after the food prepared by the plant, there is no work for the cotyledon, so it is dry and fall off. Okay, children, that's all about the germination of a seed. You don't have these many contents in the book. You have only fruits and seeds simply in half a page. So you listen carefully and read everything. Whatever I am saying, you just listen and you can get more information than the book. Okay, children? Just we will recap. Okay? Let us see from the beginning, recap, we saw about fruits and seeds. Then fruits we can get only from the flowering plants. Okay, from that the ovules can develop into seeds and the ovary can develop into fruit. Okay, after the pollination, the petals fall off. Then the embryo develops into the ovule. The ovules develop into seeds and the ovary it becomes fruit. At last you can get the ripened fruit. The petal flowers are fall away. Okay. In this flower, most of the flower, typical flowers have male reproductive part as well as the female reproductive part. Male reproductive part is called stamen and female reproductive part is called carpel or pistil. Okay, this anther transfer the pollen grains into the stigma and through the stigma to the ovary, there is a part called style. Inside the style, we have pollen tube. Through the pollen tube, the pollen that sperm or pollen transfer into the ovules. Okay, from that ovules, it's developed into seed. Okay, pollen enters into the flower's ovary and it fertilizes, and it grows into the ovules, grows into the seed, and the ovary grows into the fruit. Okay, finally the outer thicker layer of the ovary becomes the fruit's outer wall. Okay, fruit's outer wall. Okay, children. Next one, seeds and fruits. Seeds are always inside the fruit. Okay, seeds can be spread by the wind or by human or by animals, like that. Okay, then there is two important thing. The fruit can develops from the two following layers: fruit wall from the ovary wall, seed from the ovule. That already we saw that. I said next one, parts of a seed. We have first one, the outer layer of the seed is called seed coat. It can protect the seed. Okay, the next one is cotyledon. It can store the food for the baby plant. Next one is radical. Radical is the root part of a baby plant. Then hypocotyl. After radical, the hypocotyl emerges. After that, plumule emerges. Okay, plumule is the early development. It's a leaf part of a plant, baby plant. Okay, now look at this picture clearly. Seed coat, plumule. Plumule is a leaf part. Radical is the root part. Hypocotyl, it is in between radical and the epicotyl or plumule. Okay. Yes, epicotyl becomes shoot, that is leaves and stem. Hypocotyl is a connection in between the cotyledon and the radical. Then radical is a root part. Seed coat is the outer layer of a seed. Cotyledon, it can store the food for the baby plant. Okay, children, radical will emerges first. After that, plumule arises or emerges. Okay, then we have two types of seeds. One is monocotyledon seeds and dicotyledon seeds. Monocotyledon seeds produce monocot plants such as corn, maize, wheat, rice, coconut, lily, etc. These plants have only one cotyledon in their seeds. Then dicot plants have two cotyledons in their seeds. Okay, children, example soya bean, pea, then green gram, channa, peanut, almond, all those plants have dicot plants. Okay, dicot seeds. Okay, this is the picture of a germination of a seed. Okay, first the seed coat breaks and the radical comes out, emerges, followed by the hypocotyl. Then after the hypocotyl, what is that? Epicotyl emerges out, and plumule, that is the young leaf of a plant. For this, cotyledon provides food. Then the root fix into the soil, started preparing their own food. Then the cotyledon rise and fall off. Okay, children, that's all. Take your book and you just read this. After that, you have homework. Today's homework is complete chapter 8, all book back exercises. We will discuss the answer for the book back exercises in the next class. Thank you, children. Complete this book back exercise and take the photo and upload it in Google Classroom. Okay, children. Thank you.